Hi guys, welcome to the channel Basic Learning. If you like this video, please click the like button and do not forget to subscribe to our channel to get more videos like this. If you click the bell button, you will get notifications whenever we upload a new video. Here the channel trailer is playing here. If you want to check it out, you can go to the home page of our channel so that you can find it. Today our topic is spoon feeding. Spoon feeding is here, it is a word that is identical to feeding babies, that is if we have small children, then we will keep food in small parts with the help of a spoon into the small children's mouth. Here, the spoon feeding we are referring to is that of particularly the students of LRS, that is college. In college, many students want them to be spoon fed. That is, if they get any doubt, they want that doubt to be clarified within no time with each and every detail in small parts. They expect the same from the lecturers. This is what today we are going to discuss about. Actually, spoon feeding is a very bad thing. That is, spoon feeding shouldn't be encouraged, and it will also not be encouraged in any college. Some colleges might encourage. In school age, many students are habituated to it. Okay, let us go straight into our discussion. Before going to discuss about how the students are being spoon fed, we will discuss then examples of spoon feeding in day-to-day life. One common example is, previously, I think most of you use smartphones. Previously, if you want to know any weather report or if you want to play some songs, you use it to go to the Google browser and check any website that today whether it will rain or not, should I carry anything, umbrella or not. But today, after the invention of Google Assistant, the things had changed. Let us take a quick look at it. Okay, this is a smartphone. This is Samsung Galaxy M40. Now we are going to try the Google Assistant in it. I don't want to touch my phone with screen. That is, I don't want to touch the screen of this phone. Okay, let us first unlock it. With fingerprint sensor, I unlocked it. Now I am going to ask the Google Assistant. Okay, Google. Should I bring an umbrella?
Yes, rain is expected today in Vijayawada.
Let us try some more stuff. Okay, Google, play song Rowdy Baby.
Alright, Rowdy Baby by D-H-E-E, Dinush. Here it is on Ghana.
See, the song is playing. This is how the artificial intelligence has entered our life. The artificial intelligence is going to change our life a lot, believe me. Presently, people cannot live without internet. That is, internet has become part of everyone's day-to-day life. Similarly, in future, artificial intelligence will also be a part of each and everyone's life. That is, people cannot live without artificial intelligence. We will have smart homes, everything will be smart. Starting from verbs to ending with all the vehicles. That is, before we are entering our car, it will indicate us how much air pollution is being emitted from our car and when should we get it serviced and what is the fuel levels, and it will remind us with everything. We need not use our hands anymore, I think. We are not understanding whether to be happy that we are technologically advanced or we should be unhappy that our life is decreasing and people are getting new diseases, they are getting into hospitals. As the treatment is also advancing, the diseases are also advancing. This is one advent with the new technology. And one more thing I want to say is, previously people used to walk miles to earn money and get food. But presently they are walking miles to digest their food. And they are naming it morning walk or something else. That is the worst thing that present day is. That is, one more thing is, presently we are getting many apps like Big Basket. That is, if we order some groceries or fruit, something, they will come and deliver to us. People are not walking even to get the groceries. They want that Shah Rukh Khan to come and deliver. That is Big Basket. People are becoming like that. Without morning walk, they can just walk to the grocery store and bring that commodities. Okay, this is the technology. This is coming to the spoon feeding in the present day life. Here, the relation between spoon feeding and the topic I discussed now is, previously, people used to go to libraries or they used to surf internet to get the things they want. But now, everything is a word away. That is, if we ask for anything, it will be before us. that is Google Assistant or Amazon Alexa. But the most famous on Google is dominating a lot. Presently, it is entering even the Android TVs also. Sony is starting an Android TV, that is, it has its smart remote and a built-in Google Assistant. That means we need not even touch the TV remote to switch between channels. People are becoming lazy with these technologies. Previously, if you want to go to channel number 23, we used to click channel number 23. Or if you want to open Netflix, we will go to all apps and slide beside and we will open Netflix. But today, just click the voice button. Okay, Google, open Netflix. Then it will open Netflix for us. This is the present day technology and we are being spoon-fed by the technology right now. This is an example of spoon-feeding. Now we are going to discuss about spoon-feeding in students' life. What is spoon-feeding in students' life? Particularly when we come to intermediate, our lecturers will not clarify our doubts, that means in the way we want. That is, if we ask a question, they will not give the complete details about that question. It is not like that they are not interested to tell us or they don't know the subject. The case is not that. The case is that if lecturers deliver everything that we want in the way we like, then it will not improve us anything. Today we will ask one question, tomorrow we will ask one more question, and whatever the question comes, everything we will approach the professor to deal with it. It will not develop students' mind to increase. That means they will not develop mentally. One should understand the professor's intention. That is, they don't want the students to be spoon-fed. Therefore, the things you want to do is, first, suppose you got some doubt. Try it for one time. You will not get. Okay, leave it. And try it one more time. Try it thrice, four times, five times. And try it 20 times. You may not get even one day. Use 2-3 days to solve that question. And after 2-3 days, then approach the professor and say to him the effort that you had done on this problem and what are the steps you had taken and what are the approaches you took. Then he will refer to those approaches and tell you the mistake that you had done. Suppose there are 10 steps. Look, you had done a mistake in the 4th step. Like that he might guide us. This is a better way of solving your doubts rather than simply you are reading and continuously solving some practice book. In 10th question you got doubt. Immediately taking the book and running away to the professor. What will fetch it? What will it fetch to you? It will fetch nothing. It will just waste your time. It is waste of time. Therefore, do not approach the professor immediately after you are getting the doubt. And do not stand in the queue like when many people are standing. If you got doubt, you may not meet the lecturers always. Sometimes if your friend is sitting beside you, you will always disturb him. Telling what, suppose if you didn't get doubt, you may immediately, within a second, you will go to him and ask, can you please solve this sum for me? Can you please solve this sum for me? And you might ask him. And as a result, you may get it clarified. But in this process, the advantage is more for the student who clarified your doubt rather than you. Because he is investing his mind energy to solve that problem. And you just simply using your eyes and ears to listen it. What will it fetch to you? You shouldn't use only your eyes and ears to learn something. You should use your mind. You should practice on it a lot. You should work it out. Work it out in such a way that the sum should get fear of you. And if you do so, you will definitely get solution to any question you want. It may take time, but you will get the solution. If you have less time. The thing comes here. Suppose if you have less time, then do not go for these many attempts. Just go for 3-4 attempts, then ask your professor. If the time is less, he will only clarify your doubts. If the time is more, your professor will not show interest to clarify your doubts. Because if he do so, you will not be developed. This happens with many colleges. In school days, many children are habituated to be spoon-fed. It happens with many schools, particularly in the South India. That is, suppose if there is a concept and after that there are some questions, then teachers will only answer those questions and they will give the solutions. Students will write that in the notebook and they will work it out. This happens in many schools. Therefore, if this kind of process is going on in your school, then the things you have to do is, before the day the topic is dealt in your school, work it out before that day. That means you solve all the problems and tick the correct answers. And next day when teacher is teaching, you can cross check it. And you can see what the better approach your teacher is going to say you. In this way, you can develop a lot. Your skills will be developed and your brain will be developed. And this helps a lot. That means you will become a grand success. Thanks a lot for watching this video. If you like this, please click the like button. And if you want more videos like this, please click the subscribe button and click the bell icon to get notifications whenever we upload a new video. One more thing to mention here is this topic is suggested by Kalyan. Okay, if you want any topic to be discussed by us in YouTube, then you can please mention it in the comment section below or email to us. Our email is present in the description below. If you keep any topic related to education or any facts or any tutorials you want regarding anything that is in computer, if you want the Photoshop tutorials or After Effects tutorials, we will present anything that we are capable of. So please feel free and mention the topic you want in the comment section below. Therefore, we will make the next video on it. The forum is open to everyone. Thanks a lot for watching this video.